marsupials have evolved into almost every imaginable niche in the terrestrial environments of Australia. So of course we're familiar with kangaroos in the arid zone of the desert or in the temperate forests, but I also like to point out this range of evolutionary and ecological diversity that we have in mammals just in this part of our collection. Here we see two scaly-tailed possums. These are from the Kimberleys. They are a rock inhabiting possum. So of course many Australians are familiar with our old friend the brush-tailed possum and the ring-tailed possum of wooded environments. But here's one that's a rock inhabiting animal. Then we have Leadbeater's possum. It's a very localised species occurring in the tall forests not far out of Melbourne. Continuing on the theme of marsupials that live in trees, these are the striped possum, the specimens of the striped possum from the wet tropics of northeastern Australia. A wonderful, spectacular little animal, and notable for this elongated digit they have for probing for food. And then of course we start to think about the air. Australia has a number of possums that are gliders, and so we have small and large gliders. We've ranged from the feather tail glider, the smallest, up through the sugar glider and the squirrel glider, and then up to the greater gliders. So marsupials have been able to adapt to even, to some extent, to aerial environments. And then we've got predators. We have quolls, and the Tasmanian devil is a scavenger. And then we have the mouse-like or shrew-like smaller species of and genera of marsupials. These are antechinus, and these live in the undergrowth in forests and woodlands. So this range of species, covering an ecological and geographical range of the continent really, neatly show how marsupials have evolved an enormous range of lifestyles and biology in the Australian continent.